flexyPage, innovative display solutions. In this tutorial, we will show you how to start up your flexyPage display for the first time and to adapt it to your individual requirements in just a few steps. All you need apart from your flexyPage display is a device with internet access, such as PC, tablet or smartphone, and an up-to-date browser of your choice. To start your flexyPage display, first connect it to a power supply. While the display is booting, a system information window will pop up for a few seconds that contains information about serial number, firmware version, and IP address. Type the IP address that is shown on the system information window into your browser. Alternatively, you can find the IP address written on the back of your flexyPage display. Now you can log in with your username and password. After logging in successfully, you can see the flexyPage web editor, which is separated into five different parts. The main menu is located on the top and contains, amongst others, the maintenance menu, transfer settings, and a language selection. Beneath the main menu is the display preview, in which you can move, delete, and adjust widgets. The smaller buttons above the display preview contain functions as toggle grid, copy and paste, or erase layer. The quick access buttons to the right of the display preview offer you an option to switch quickly between important menus like the widgets library, the house editor, or hardware settings. The menu shows what is hidden behind the quick access buttons. Here you can regulate any settings related to the widgets and the display. By clicking the Save Project button under the menu, all the settings you have made in the web editor will be saved and shown on your display shortly after. With every flexyPage display, you will get a pre-installed standard design, which can be adjusted with a web editor to your personal needs in just a few quick steps. In a screen design with lift buttons, the widgets have already been linked with a house editor. But first, the buttons on the layout have to be adjusted. Delete the appropriate amount of lift button widgets or add some with the copy and paste function according to the amount of floors in your building. If you add a lift button to the layout, it first has to be allocated to the right floor. By clicking on the widget, you can go to the settings in the menu and type in the correct floor number, the undermost floor always being 1. Now the display text has to be customized in the house editor. The quickest way to go to the house editor is via the quick access button. Here you can set the correct amount of floors for your building by deleting or adding floors to the menu. By clicking on a floor, a selection menu will open up where you can allocate an alias for the floor and add any amount of residents. You can add a name or customized logo for every single resident. After you have adapted all your settings in the house editor, save them by clicking on the button and the changes will be shown on your display. If you want to change the preset image, click on the DR Show widget and reset the existing image first. Go to the slideshow settings and choose a different image from the library or upload a new image. With the DR Show widget, you can also choose several images at a time. On the display, they will be played as a slideshow. You can also change the logo at the top right of the display the same way as the image. This this widget can be adjusted in size very easily by clicking and dragging so that it fits the format of your logo. To display your own individual RSS feed, click on the RSS Reader widget, go to the RSS feed settings, and paste or type in the URL to your feed. After saving your project, your feed will be displayed as a text on the display. Last but not least, you can adjust the lift information text by again clicking on the text area widget and changing the text under the settings. With these adjustments, you can customize your display very quickly and easily and get it ready to use for your elevator. FlexyPage. Innovative display solutions.